important to understand from our panelists here how they see this entire transformation which is progressing in the sector and what has been their own journey as they have walked this path before us. I hope this panel
is expecting big jump in our revenue, efficiency, safety culture and business improvement in business processes due to digitalization. We have adopted many technologies. John is here, I was just talking to him. We have adopted landmark software. So I was talking to him how we can upgrade it. So regularly we are adopting technology.
Methodology like this so that we can bring in more velocity of iteration in the models. Okay, so the DNNs, the discrete neural networks, are also used as synthetic data. There are certain models, for example, is available there in Marcosi model, etc. We try to update those models and also use certain hybrid approaches.
It actually comes in two ways. One is, there is a set of users, there are a set of players who feel anxious that there is a finite timeline for use of oil and gas. So why let it stay on under the ground? Let's get it out faster. Let us monetize it faster. So that is one stream of thought, one school of thought, which tries to look at it that way. And we are seeing that in many countries. But the other one, and which is more true from an India perspective, that look, energy continues to be, fossil fuels, energy continues to be vital for India's growth.
The dedication and praiseworthy performance of our industry peers. We have gathered here to recognize the various initiatives by oil and gas players in five major categories, including
gas having commissioned,
planting over 5,000 sanctions of location which are traces to reduce fugitive emission papers which were.
First of all, on behalf of DGH, I express my heartfelt gratitude to all the respected dignitaries and distinguished guests from oil and gas
community. Mr. General Coordination, Mr. Akash Goyal, to deliver the vote of thanks. Sir, please.
Pankaj Jain, sir, Secretary MOPNG.